Hi all, it's me Anne from Geeks of Green, and in today's video, I will be propagating the cuttings that I took from my balcony in the last video. We will be putting it in different media and I hope you really enjoy this video. If you haven't seen the previous video, I will leave the link for it on screen or in the description down below. Do go and check that out as well. So I'm all set, I'm inside, I have opened up the table. I have a couple of things ready to start propagating my cutting. So what I have here is, I have these semi-hydroponic pots with a lot of slats for the water to be absorbed, and it needs another container for the outside, and this goes inside it. So I have another one right here, some more leca, and I have different types of granulates. This is one type, and then I have also these granulates which Plant Princess sent to me on Instagram. She's selling this, so if you want to buy granulates, you can also buy it from her. Then I have some sphagnum moss, which I will also use. And I also have this nice mix, which Plantastic Sunny sent to me. It has got rice husk and it's got cocoa peat. It's got a little bit of perlite and a few other things, which make it a nice medium, which will hold moisture and it's good for the plants to grow. Over here, I also have my homemade mix, which I have put videos about in the past. I will leave the links for you in the description how to make this mix, and I'm going to use this a lot today to propagate quite a few of my plants. It's a moisture retaining mix and it is airy and it is well draining as well, so it won't hold a lot of water. It won't remain soggy, but it will remain moist as well, which will help my cuttings to grow. I also have these empty containers which I had lying around. They're pretty. I want to use them in my setup. So I will be putting a few cuttings in these as well for water propagation. Since I have all this ready, let's get started. So I've roughly segregated my cuttings and made a rough plan of what will go into what kind of medium or what kind of propagation I'm going to do for each cutting. And I might change my mind as I go along. Let's see what happens. So first, I want to get done with the water propagation because it's the easiest, and I have these pretty containers. So I've chosen 4 cuttings to go into these containers. Now, it's best if you wash your cuttings, because if there are bugs or if there are pests and all, it's easier to get your cutting to propagate easily. So I have washed the scissors this color, and I'll get rid of this last leaf to expose the node. Okay, so the leaf is gone and this will go into probably this, or maybe it'll go into this one. This looks good. The cutting is already drooping, so I'm not very sure if it will survive. This is the first time I'm trying to propagate the scissors this color. Now this Erubescens, Philodendron Erubescens Ruby, I think, yes. This one, also I will get rid of one leaf and probably it will go into this. It looks good here. So now this ficus, I will lose this last leaf again, and I have the node exposed. It probably will go into this one or maybe into this one. Yeah, looks better in this, I think. Looks good this way. So I've washed these cuttings and I'm hoping that they do well. Okay, so this here is the Ashenanthus, and I think I'll just shorten it a bit. There you go. So this will go into this. Now it's time to fill these containers with water. Just quickly do that. So I've put 4 cuttings in water, and the Cissus discolor and the Ashenanthus, I'm not sure, and even this one, the ficus, I've never propagated before. So I think water is the best way to go right now. The cuttings are really drooping, especially this one. So I don't know. Let's see how it works. I'll keep it under artificial light and I will hope that it really roots. After I put all of these into some form of media, after a few weeks, I'll wait and I'll watch and see the roots grow. And I will put an update video of what survived, what rooted, what did not. And I'll tell you what happens to each of these cuttings. Okay, so now we're done with the water propagation. Now we'll move on to the soil propagation. I have selected a few plants which I know will do well and will grow well directly in soil. I'm going to put them in small little pots and directly plant them onto the soil. So I have this white container. It's a hanging container. And I will be putting in it my soil mix and these Syndapsis cuttings. There's nothing much to it. I just have to ensure that there's a drainage hole and I'm going to fill it up. Now I'm going to quickly cut this up node by node. I'm going to use each node and fill up the whole space and get them to root. Okay. I'm also going to use the leafless nodes because yes, in my experience, they all grow. So, the ones that have one leaf like this, I will probably place them this way. I will probably hold this cutting down with a wire. Do that later. This one's quite long, so I'm going to just keep it as it is. Some of them may not survive, but I've got enough cuttings. As you can see, the roots are, the aerial roots are pretty thick and healthy, and they really want to help the plant to grow well. Now these roots are a little too long, it's difficult to bury them, so I'm just going to trim them a bit and then poke them inside. So we're done. This pot is full of cuttings. All I have to do is water it and see that it drains from the bottom. I'm just going to catch the water in the other pot. It doesn't have drainage hole in. Now this mix is pretty dry, so I have to wait for it to completely soak. So I have to water slowly, but ensure that it comes down through the drainage hole. It's beginning to drip. You can see that it's dripping. So it'll take some time to drip. I'm going to leave it like this. Get it out later. So now I've got this money plant. I'm going to do the same thing that I did with my Syndapsis with this plant as well, and I will put it in a pot. Now I have two cuttings here. One is the variegated Hedracium and this one is the non-variegated one. This is the Brazil. So I'm taking just small pots, two small pots filled with the soil mix that I have, and I'm not going to separate this. Okay, I will probably cut this down somewhere here and then I'm going to just poke it in because the cutting is pretty bushy and I would like it to hang this way. I have a few of these nodes left, which I will definitely put to use by pushing them into that pot of soil. If it roots, great. We'll have some more cuttings. So that's it. This is how this plant will look and it will continue to grow. So I'm going to water this later. Same thing with this Brazil cutting. It's a nice bushy cutting. So I'm just going to cut it somewhere here. Okay. And I'm going to poke it in. Okay. So now my pedatum cuttings, Philodendron pedatum, get rid of the excessively long aerial root, and I'm going to put them in these planters. So this is again to give away to somebody because I've got a lot of pedatum cuttings that I have propagated. Some are sitting in hydroponics and some in water. They're all over my house and they're doing pretty well.
So let's just get these done. I'm putting two cuttings in one of these and then one in the other.
Since these plants are solo cuttings, they're finding it difficult to stand in the soil. So I'm going to fasten it with these wire bits. So I'm going to fasten it with these wire bits and I'm also going to tie them together to support each other so that they remain standing, and a little bit of soil to top it off. I've also kept this brick right here to give it some support so it remains standing. So I'm almost coming to the end of propagating these cuttings. I have my raven left, I have the begonias left, and I have the Monstera Albo Borsigiana left. So what I'm going to do is first focus on these because I'm running out of media, running out of leca and things like that. So I got to finish the Monstera first, and then probably if these cuttings are left, I'll just plonk them in water and for now let them be that way till I get more leca and more pots and things like that. Okay, so we have six cuttings and we're going to try and propagate them in different ways just to see how they work out. Okay, so I already have some leca in this semi-hydroponic pot, and I have a pot here outside. I'm going to use it as a reservoir which holds water, the outer pot, and I'm going to place my cutting right inside it. So I'm going to select a good healthy cutting of one beautiful variegated leaf. Okay, so again, it's got a long aerial root, we don't need that much. I'm gonna chop it off a little more. Okay, in you go. So I have placed my cutting right in this pot. I filled up some leca and I'm going to place this cutting right here and I'm going to pour more leca in. Now it's time to put some water. So my semi-hydroponic setup is ready. I will probably put this up in my shelf that's right here under the spotlight. Okay. Now as you can see, this leaf is half scorched and this is the white side that is scorched. Okay, but you can see the variegation that is there right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to probably put it in some sphagnum moss. So what I'm going to do right here is trim the roots a bit, like I did before. Okay. And in the semi-hydroponic pot, I'm going to fill it up with sphagnum moss. Okay. I love the smell of sphagnum moss. It's so good. I'll probably need something to hold down the plant. I'm going to wet this so that it's easier. So I've already wetted this very precious sphagnum moss. And I'm going to put this cutting in. Like this. And cover it up with a little more moss. This is enough. Sphagnum moss remains moist. I'm going to water it thoroughly. I've never done this with a semi-hydroponic pot. So let's see. Keep observing it. Ensure that the moss remains moist. Now this leaf will surely die, but I have faith in the node and the cutting, the stem. So it will throw out new leaves eventually. I hope that it works out fine and this plant really grows well. Now the next two cuttings of my Monstera will go into soil mediums, and one soil medium will be the one that I have at home and the other one will be the one that Plantastic Sunny sent to me. Over here I'm going to just take the non-variegated ones. Let's see what happens to these. So I have this last two cuttings left. This one I'm going to try putting it in a bottle of water, and because this leaf is hardly, you know, alive. So I'm going to put it in water and see. And this one that has two leaves is going to go again into semi-hydroponics. Now, I do not have the semi-hydroponics pot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a regular pot that has a lot of drainage holes at the bottom. And I'm going to use it like this as a cash pot. I hope that I have enough leka. Okay, I just need a little more and I think I have that. Okay, I found a little bit of leka. That's all that I have. I've exhausted all of it. Okay, now time to water them. Okay, so this is done as well. And now I'm going to go and find a container for this one and try and water propagate it. So I have this very cute round planter, which is, I think there is one piece available on the Geeks of Green store. It's almost all sold out. This one, I'm going to use it for this particular plant. This one doesn't have a drainage hole, so I will be filling it with water. Since I wanted a planter that has a wider mouth to take in my cutting, this seems to be perfect. I know the leaf is dead, but let's hope for some growth and some new leaves on this cutting. So this one's right here. So now I have these granulates right here. I'm going to use these granulates as well for these cuttings, my Morrisamy cutting. Just poke it in. I'm not putting it upside down. It is somehow the leaves are growing downwards. So don't get confused. Now, since the begonia cuttings were the only ones that were left, I have this pot. I filled it with water and I have cut and put all the cuttings together inside. This is a very temporary setup because I don't have any soil left. So I will be mixing up some more soil and then putting these into its respective pots in soil directly and hoping that they will grow. So this is my begonia pot for now. It's a very temporary thing. I also want to quickly talk about this erubescence that I have planted. As you can see, it's in a ceramic planter. Now, I really apologize because the battery of one of my cameras went out and it didn't record what I said and how I did. The process is not recorded. I already potted it, so I didn't want to remove it and do it again. It would be too much of a hassle. So I'll just quickly talk about this. This pot is a ceramic pot. The reason that I chose it is it's heavy and it will hold the cutting in place. A plastic pot would probably topple. So it's a very heavy cutting, a huge cutting, and it is held in place because of this ceramic pot. The second thing that I want to tell you about this one is that because the leaves are all so big and it doesn't have a root system to support the plant, most of these leaves may die out. I have had experience with huge cuttings that I've got, every single big leaf died out, and eventually the plant started growing root and new leaves popped. This happened with my pinnatum. I had put stories on Instagram some time back and I've even put a post about it. So yeah, I'm expecting to lose all of these leaves and then afterwards gain new leaves and have a healthy plant. So even if all the leaves go, it's absolutely okay. I'm expecting it. One more thing that I have to be mindful of is water these plants gently because they're in soil right now. The roots are not holding on to the soil and the soil is loose. So if there are such cuttings that are coming out, you can hold them in place with a wire and they will eventually grow. So I have to just be mindful of how I water them, not under the hose. And I will be placing them under some under artificial light, some under in places where there is a little bit of natural light. So let's see how it grows and I will soon put an update of how these plants are faring. A few videos back, I had propagated my Syndapsis pictus and my Monstera Peru. So I would like to just quickly show you the update of them. They are still not doing very great. If you can see, the leaves are a little droopy still. This one looks quite perky and none of them have died. None of the cuttings have died as of now. Some of them are just looking a little droopy, but you can see it's still going steady and I think it will grow. So this is an update of this one. So here's an update of the Monstera Peru that was in a humidity box. You can see it's looking so much better than the Synapse suspectus. Controlled environment, and they look like they're rooting. Oh my, you can see, who's this? There's a little slug right here. So slugs have managed to creep in. I got to remove them. Now when I look at all of these plants, so many pots that I got out of simple propagations, I find it completely rewarding for all the hard work that I had to put in. You can gift these plants to your loved ones. You can keep it in your own house and grow more of them. And you can even sell them because, yes, they do fetch good prices. So if you want to do something on the side, you can always propagate your plants and sell them on Instagram. There are many people who are willing to buy them. So that is something that you can also do. I hope this video really encourages you to propagate more plants. Do share in the comments down below. What are you planning to do if you have already started propagating plants or not in this season? And wish you all the best. I hope to see you soon in another video. Till then, stay green.